All right. And I just have to scroll down to the theme song. Look for the damn thing. Then the show can begin.
With our shams, with our shams, with our shams, with our shams. When the crowd gets fussy, when the floor gets dusty, when your play gets rusty, with our shams, with our shams. When your broom smells funny, when a hex takes your money, what's gonna save you, honey? Just with our shams, with our shams. All you witches and all your old magicians, it's time to start listening to with our shams, with our shams.
Dead air plays for a couple seconds, and then we go.
With our shams, with our shams, with our shams, with our shams. When the crowd gets fussy, when the floor gets dusty, when your play gets rusty, with our shams, with our shams. When your broom smells funny, when a hex takes your money, what's gonna save you, honey? Just with our shams, with our shams. All you witches and all your old magicians, it's time to start listening to with our shams, with our shams. shine, intellectual capacity that I believe. It's in the air, but everywhere is the ultimate act of treason. So few could be aware that their nation's heart is bleeding. But oh, when the violence has begun, we decree the pen more mighty than the gun. While the fools believe is one in this unrepentant age of unreason. Just to think that not so long ago was a man. One in perfect harmony. It requires common sensibility to teach an intellectual capacity that I believe. It's in the air, but everywhere is the ultimate act of treason. So few could be aware that their nation's heart is bleeding.
Start a song, but it takes them a longer time to finish the song.
Yep.
Back in my day, we put them through 15 encores one fucking night. Finally, the stage crew and people just wanted to go home and turned on the fucking house lights. They still came out and did another encore with the house lights on.
That's funny.
We just kept them coming. People on TikTok today asking about my favorite band and they want to hear some. So I said that I would play some Damn. So that was at least, what, a double shot? Hard to do a triple shot of the Damn to take all night.
You played Democracy first, I think.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But the Damned. On Witterson's Radio, you know. Still, all these years later, the Damned being the first punk band, 1974, their first single, and still, music to speak to our troubled times.
Yeah.
And they're never going to give us Democracy.
It's always topical.
And, you know, now, you know, we're here in the United States of America, we have a man in power that's actually trying to destroy our democracy. And
Definitely has damaged it beyond
actively trying to destroy our democracy and not even pretending that he's not.
You know, in the last week, he's entertained the idea of martial law and having the military rerun our elections. And still, even now, his supporters have nothing to say. Martial law and the military running, okay with that, but you worry about the deep state.
Well, the other thing is the COVID relief bill finally passed, and one of the reasons it took so long is because the Democrats wanted to be able to give more money to people, and the Republicans didn't. So they went back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. So they finally, both houses came up with something. Finally agreed to it. You know, it's far, far from perfect, but it's what they came up with. And now Trump is demanding that everybody get $2,000 or else he'll veto it. And it's like, I fully would love to see that happen, but that's what the Democrats have been asking for all along.
Original number.
Trump was never even involved in the process. He never came out and said, I think everybody should get 2,000. You know, it's like all of a sudden yesterday after they passed it, they're waiting for him to sign it. All of a sudden, he makes this demand. And so Nancy Pelosi is like, let's do it. I mean, that's what you wanted in the first place. So we're fine with it. The Republicans aren't fine with it. But the idiots who support Trump are like, I went on social media on their, you know, little page, and they're like, see, this is what I'm talking about. A man, the president that cares about the people and puts the people first. So, like, they don't even understand what's happening, that's what we, the libtards, wanted the entire time. And now Trump's making this demand, and they're, like, patting him on the back for it.
Are you sick of winning yet?
Yeah. So, like, he doesn't give a shit. He's just, you know, trying to throw a monkey wrench in it. My understanding is that it was veto-proof, so I don't really understand
what
any of
this... He just vetoed the defense spending bill, and that's veto-proof, too.
I was told that was veto-proof.
Yeah.
And so I don't know why he's doing it, and I've read a bunch of stuff that basically where he would be kind of embarrassed if he vetoed something that was veto proof and then they overrode his veto, that would symbolize an embarrassment to him. So why is he doing this knowing that they're going to overturn if it's veto proof, then they're going to overturn his veto. I don't even know why I wasted his time. But it's just silly. You know, as much as I prefer 2,000 to 600, he's not doing it because he cares about how much the people are going to get. He's doing it for attention and to slow down. What he's really doing is he's slowing down the process instead of signing it and having benefits start quickly. I think they expire on the 26th. Mm-hmm. And so they would, you know, be more or less seamless. But now, I guess I heard he has until January 3rd.
Well, that's exactly it. Whatever happens here, he's just delayed the thing that's beyond necessary now. People are going to, we're going to have mass evictions the day after fucking Christmas. Estimated 20 million new homeless people.
Yeah.
20 million new homeless people in the U.S. are just like regular people that fucking, their job was affected because of COVID.
So he's just, you know, postponing it, but you know, verbally, like trying to make it out like he's the good guy who's, you know, fighting for us, and like, you know, he wants us to have this much money even though he never said a word about it before. And people truly are stupid enough to fall for it and cheer him on for doing this. They're so stupid. I can't even deal with it anymore.
Well, and okay, so we do attract those stupid people on the YouTube broadcast. We'll always get a couple Trumplicans in there, and you're stupid. Okay, if you're a Trumplican, you're stupid. And you're beyond stupid to still keep buying this shit. Now, first of all, your party, the Republican Party, you know how much they wanted to give in the stimulus package? Nothing. They fought for nothing. They held on to nothing for weeks and weeks and weeks until the Democrats fucking got them up to $600 fucking dollars. Yes.
That's why it took so long, because, you know, they didn't want to pass it with nothing.
All other countries that are getting through this thing, all the people call their tax money, you know, I heard a guy in Ireland, they put it in the pot. Yeah. They put it in the pot. And the more people that are putting it in the pot, the more you have to take out of the pot when the people need help from the pot.
Isn't that the point, partially?
Yes. And the Trumplicans that are on our page, you're all stupid, and you're all going to be saying the same thing. So even though we can't interact in this fashion, let me cut you off right now. The omnibus spending bill, which was attached to the coronavirus relief bill and was passed at the same time, were not the same thing, had our aid to other countries, business interests in the United States. It was the spending bill for the next fucking year for all of our basic expenditures that this country engages in, and had nothing to do with the coronavirus relief bill. And this is what Trump attacked, what all the Trumplicans attacked. Like, why are we giving all this money to fucking South Korea, or fucking we're giving it to Ethiopia and shit? It's like, that's not in the coronavirus relief bill. That's the omnibus spending bill, which also needed to be passed before the end of the year. This is where the government catches up with all of the work that they didn't fucking do all fucking year long. Are you people just waking up? Have you not been paying attention? This is what always fucking
just
happens.
Just like all the rest of us.
Yeah, they get all this shit done right at the fucking last fucking minute that had to be done. It's like the omnibus spending bill,
so
you know,
they could
the
go to,
budget for
so they could
all
take
of our
their
endeavors.
Recess.
Yes,
if
yes.
If they weren't waiting to take their recess, they wouldn't do it now either.
And all day long, you know, I got Trumplicans fucking repeating that shit. It's like, well, you shouldn't be giving all this money to all these other countries. Like, well, you know, that's already in the budget. We're already going to be giving money to all those countries because that's what we do. We help people out around, and I'm sure Trump's done away with way, you know, we're probably helping way fewer people than we ever were in the rest of the world. But we still do that. It had nothing to do with the relief bill, and the money coming from that didn't come from the pot that the relief bill would come from. And I keep fucking telling you people this, and I still get Trumplicans up in here. Are you not fucking listening? I just went through this with my fucking kid in social studies. Taxation without representation was the foundation of the nation, people. That was the whole fucking reason. We didn't get represented by our government, but they took our taxes. Our taxes did nothing to benefit us, so we broke away from England and had a little tiff about it for a, you know, couple decades.
And here we are.
And here we fucking are. Our taxes are to take care of the people. They still have the tax money. They have not spent all of our tax money, and here it is, tax time coming again. Time for us to pay fucking for more money. The reason we pay them taxes is for times like these. It's our fucking money. People, I'm going to get Trumplicans when they finally get their fucking stimulus check. They go, I got a great check from Donald Trump, and it has his picture on it and shit. It's like, it's not his fucking picture. That's our picture. It's your picture. It's my picture. It's everybody's fucking picture. It's our fucking money. It's what we put into the pot to take care of all of us when shit like this happens. And we got Republicans don't want to give any money. They didn't want to give any money at this late stage of the game. And just let all those Americans suffer.
Well, you know, and the problem is they keep talking about the deficit and how they're concerned about the deficit, but they're the ones who created the deficit.
They always create
by all
deficit.
These tax breaks. Like, yes. If everybody, you know, I'm not even saying anybody should pay like a higher percentage or even, I'm not even saying that. Just pay at least the same rate that the kid at McDonald's pays.
Yeah.
You know,
Obama got us through the last recession, and as usual, as always, and fuck you, Trumplicans, Democrats have always left a surplus. They've always left more money behind. The Republicans have always left a deficit. They always fucking do. How is this conservative? How is that conservative? How is that less government? Where, if we didn't spend all that money on government, where'd all the fucking money go?
That's why they, yeah. That's why they cut all the programs, you know, that some of us, like myself, do care about, because they don't have the money to pay for them because of all the tax breaks.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and you know,
like, I understand you don't want a deficit. Okay, nobody wants a deficit, but you know, they don't want to look at why that's there in the first place.
Mm-hmm. And you know, the thing's thousands of pages long.
It's like five and a half thousand pages
the coronavirus long. Relief bill. And you know, I hear tell. I don't really know about. Tax breaks for the wealthy, some corporate welfare in there.
The three martini lunch.
The three martini lunch.
There's something called a three martini lunch. I never heard about it before, but it basically is like an expensive lunch that, you know, probably costs like hundreds of dollars, where you have like a supposed lunch meeting. So they want to, you know, keep the ability for people to write that off as a business expense.
Yeah, and
the three martini lunch, so you can imagine.
And that's fucked up, you know. It always pisses me off when somebody tries to pass a bill and people sneak in all kinds of other shit in the bill, knowing that people are going to lose attention and not read anymore.
It's like people are getting sick, people are dying, people are losing their homes, people aren't paying their bills. You can't just have one fucking martini for now.
Mm-hmm. And then three. Corporations getting huge stimulus checks, shit like that.
Well, the loans. Remember the PPE loans? Like, they gave millions. I don't remember exactly how much, but it was more than millions of dollars to fucking Kanye West, who had a profit of, I don't know, was it like $7 billion or something?
Yeah.
Like, he hasn't lost any money, but he, you know, motherfucker that he is, he applied anyway. I wouldn't be able to, like, sleep at night if I had the audacity to apply for one of those, being in his financial situation.
Yeah.
But motherfucker applied for it, and he got one for several million dollars. I know people who really are struggling, like they're sole owners of a small business. They can't get loans. And so what is this?
Taxation without representation.
He made a profit, and they're just giving him millions of dollars. I don't believe you have to pay that back.
No.
So, and these people who truly do need it aren't getting it. That's the world we live in.
And again, I'm going to take you to, you know, social studies. It's fresh in my fucking mind. The Declaration of Independence says specifically the governments are here to provide their people with three things: life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. That's their only fucking job. That money should be going to people's life, liberty, and their ability to pursue happiness, you know, not living in a fucking cardboard box on Skid Row. It's our fucking money. There was other things I was going to rant about, but I got lost in the first rant. Wants to declare martial law. Trumpites are okay with that. Wants to have the military come in and redo the elections. Trumpites are okay with that. And I'm glad that you're here on YouTube. I usually ban each one of you when you come across, so you'll probably only hear it one time. But y'all are scum. You're the scum of the fucking earth. You have engaged in supporting treason. Your president's committing treason. A lot of your GOP senators and House members are committing treason and sedition. And you're backing them. And it doesn't matter what happens. What's happening now could be the thing that destroys democracy as we know it. And you're okay with that. Trump's okay with that because your guy lost and because he lost. To continue down that road at this late stage of the game means that you're so unwoke that she'll never wake up. And that's okay. We're gonna pack you all up, and we're gonna ship you off to an island somewhere, and you can go have your white homeland and shit. And we won't have to deal with you anymore.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Ooh, that's dead air. Well, I was waiting to see if you had anything to say.
No, I was waiting for you to play a song.
Oh, you want me to play a song? I'm going to play a song, damn it.
It seems like it's been...
Blossoms on his early grave. Walk away, me boy, walk away, me boy, and by morning we'll be free. Wipe that golden tear from your mother, dear, and raise what's left of the flag for me. Then the rosary beads, count them, one, two, three, fell apart as they hit the floor. In our garb of black, we must pay respect to the colour we're born to mourn. Walk away, me boys, walk away, me boys, by morning we'll be free. Wipe the golden tear from your mother, dear, raise what's left of the flag for me. Sword, but son, a bullet fired from a shapeless ghost to put the raise what's left of the flag from me.
Flogging Molly on Wittershins Radio. And what do we hear? Bad Religion before that. We love us some Bad Religion over here.
Yeah, we do.
You know, as long as they've got music that speaks to our troubled times, and we're going to have a new lineup over here.
It always does.
Wittershins Radio. Winter solstice happened. The Christmas star that's really two planets conjuncting happened. The age of Aquarius, I guess,
happened on the 21st. Yeah. Today's the 23rd.
So, are we enlightened yet? Have you undergone a consciousness shift?
Yeah, I have.
You have?
I feel a lot more enlightened than I did before Monday.
Really?
Somehow everything's just falling into place, and I've developed a deep understanding for an appreciation of. For things that I normally would have taken for granted.
Yeah. That makes sense.
So I'm more enlightened.
Yeah. Well, they still argue out there. There's still astrologers out there. I think that Jade Soluna was just arguing that it hasn't happened yet.
Age of Aquarius?
Yeah. And they've been arguing, like, back, you know, in the 80s, I remember them, you know, people arguing whether we were in it or whether it was coming, and back and forth. It's like, okay, an age is like 2,000 years, I believe. It's calculable. I don't understand why there's this, like, huge disagreement.
Somehow we know, or we think that the Sphinx was constructed in the age of Leo.
Yeah.
So somebody has some way to measure all that.
Yeah, there's it's measurable. I don't know the measurements off the top of my head, but I believe it was like 2,000 years for each age.
I kind of thought it was like 3,000 or 4,000 years.
It could be. It could be. I don't know. But nonetheless, it's a fixed calculation.
I'm gonna you keep talking.
If we know, you know, when the last age happened, why are astrologers arguing to this day? And could they just stop it and just tell us already? But at any rate, my ancestors always talked about these changes in ages, and there was always a change in human consciousness when an age shifted. But I think the problem is with our millennial witches.
You know what?
Everything needs to happen in 60 seconds or less.
You're right. Ages. Exactly 2,000 years each.
Ooh, I got it.
In this approach, the ages are usually neatly aligned so that the Aries age is found from 2000 BC to AD 1. Yeah, because Aries is first in the zodiac. Mm-hmm. That makes sense. Pisces, AD 1 to AD 2000. Well, Aquarian age, AD 2000 to AD 4,000. So are we like 20 years off?
So that means
we'd
be 20 years into the age of Aquarius.
That's what I'm trying to...
Why are they arguing? Maybe if I understood and the argument.
This one says exactly 2,000, and this one says approximately 2,160 years. The approximate 2,160 years for each age corresponds to the average time it takes for the vernal equinox to move from one constellation of the zodiac into the next. This average can be computed by dividing the Earth's 25,800-year gyroscopic precession period by 12, the number of the zodiacal signs. Okay, well, either so, okay. Then this says exactly 2,000 years.
All right, so the disagreement continues. And the thing is, those are both Wikipedia. So
those are
two of the same source disagreeing with itself or each other. Well, it's Wikipedia, so...
We're living in the age of Pisces. Unfortunately, I don't know how old this is. Oh, this is just from 2016. Hold on. Are we still in the age of Pisces? Let's see. This is from 2016, so that doesn't matter. But the answer to that is yes. let's see.
I thought there was something below all that. Yes, when does... Oh.
See this? Is 2020 the age of Aquarius? Astrologers have hotly debated when the age of Aquarius begins and when it ends. Some claim it began in 1900, but most agree it starts on the 21st of December 2020 with the Grand Conjunction. So this backs up that it started on the 21st, which was 2 days ago on Monday.
And we had all those hippies running around singing about the dawning of the age of Aquarius. I mean, how much is a dawn of an age, I guess? Yeah. I don't know.
This is the dawning. Okay, when does age of Aquarius begin? I'm going to look at this one, too.
Earth skies. This one.
Astronomers. Okay.
Leonardo da Vinci.
Let's see. The cycle of precession lasts 25,800 years for the 12 constants, so for all of them, which is 12. So, yeah, if you divide that number by 12, then you see how many. Yeah, so this one says roughly every 2,150 years. The sun's position at the time of the March or vernal, it just bounced.
Oh, I hate
March or vernal equinox. Wait, it just did it again. Equinox moves in front of a new zodiac constellation. The age of Aquarius begins when the March equinox point moves out of the constellation Pisces and into the constellation Aquarius. When will that be? There's no definitive answer. Various interpretations give different answers to this often asked question. So it's not going to do anything?
We Widdershins are happy to help clarify and confuse you at the same time.
Yeah.
as we do so to ourselves.
As we are. Yeah, we don't wish anything for you that we wouldn't do for ourselves.
That's right. Okay. We're all into this together.
Okay, so yeah, this just like goes right into it. So basically, we don't know.
Basically, we don't know.
I don't know. I mean, I did find, one source that backs up the December 21st thing. And one of them, I think, said that it might have started in 1930? I thought I read that. So I don't know. But all I do know is that I feel more enlightened. So this is my age of Aquarius.
All right. So it's working, faster for you.
Yeah.
But these things tend to take time. And clearly, we look...
I've been practicing.
Our external world, there's a microcosm and a macrocosm. Our external world is... pretty much as crazy as it was, or maybe crazier.
I think it's crazier.
Like after the solstice, it starts like entertaining martial law and shit.
Yeah.
I think he started entertaining it
a little bit before the 21st.
Yeah, but the age of Aquarius is truly the age of reason.
That means he will be overthrown. And he will hang his head in shame and slither off with his tail between his legs.
I don't know if he's ever going to hang his head in shame. He should, but he's a narcissist. That would take some self-reflection.
I know, but that's why he's so pissed is because he's embarrassed.
Yeah.
That's why they're saying it was unlikely that he was going to veto anything, knowing that they had the numbers to override the veto, and they were specifically saying that that would be a source of embarrassment for him. But look, he did it anyway. He vetoed the military one.
Yeah,
I think it's like the people. I mean, like him or hate him, he did have some advisors who sort of knew what they were talking about, and. Those are the ones who've been edged away, and they've kind of, tried to distance themselves. Like, right now, the people that he's, really, plotting with and talking to and stuff are the crazies. There's nobody left. Like I said, you like him or hate him, he did have people who, knew what they were doing. And now they're gone. And he's got, crackpots. Like Rudy Giuliani and Sidney Powell.
Yes.
And I don't know, the MyPillow guy. I mean, seriously, it's at that point. It's at that point. Like, everybody else is like, no. Like, even, you know, people like, what the fuck is his name? John Bolton. I mean, he was let go a while ago. But, you know, people who did know what they were doing and, you know, wouldn't go as crazy as Trump needs people to go in order to prove their loyalty. And so he's out. And, you know, Bill Barr's out. I mean, everybody. Kellyanne Conway, like, she left, you know, apparently on good terms to, like, hang out with her family or whatever. But I'm sure it somehow, like, crept into her mind that, okay, maybe, like, it's really a bad idea to stick with this guy right now.
Well, I heard,
not that I like Kellyanne Conway, but, you know,
I was watching an episode of the Young Turks today, and they had this thing about, you know, that whole conversation that went on and all the people that were involved, talking about martial law and
Michael
Flynn. In from their sources, at some point there's that the crazy kind of lawyer with the conspiracy theories.
Sidney Powell.
Okay, Powell. Giuliani called her out, mm-hmm. and said that,
well,
she
remember,
was ridiculous.
Trump called her out, like, when she first showed her face, they totally
hold on. When she and Flynn were advocating that Trump declare martial law, mm-hmm. the story was, mm-hmm. Giuliani said, mm-hmm. no, that's you're going too far. That's crazy.
So, like, is he still saying that now, though? If it continues to be discussed,
even if temporarily,
yeah.
in this universe, mm-hmm. in that crazy world going on in the fucking White House, Giuliani was once the voice of reason. It may never happen again. We need to sit with this moment for just a minute.
Well, listen, there's a lot of that stuff happening because Mitch McConnell is also the voice of reason. Like, when did you think that was ever going to happen? He's telling the Senate, yeah. do not take part in this circus that they're going to try on the 6th. He told them, and he publicly acknowledged that Biden won. You know, it took him a while, but eventually, you know, he was waiting for the Electoral College. So I have to give him props for not moving the goalpost back like the rest of them are. Like, he took that and was like, okay, he's the president-elect. And he said something about it publicly. And that's why Trump hates him now. So there's some people, you know, it's like, as smarmy as I think Mitch McConnell is, he's got that, like, tiny little grain of, like, he's only going to go so far. But some of these other people, I don't know where their boundary is.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess Rudy Giuliani has his boundary. Mitch McConnell has his boundary. I still have yet to hear any sort of semblance of any kind of sense from Lindsey Graham. Mm.
And then there's the 20 crazy pardons Trump just issued for all kinds of
contractors convicted of civilian massacre.
Yes.
He pardoned them.
Well, and that's I'm glad you touched on that one, because the reason that he did that was because those contractors were from Blackwater, USA, mm-hmm. and the guy that runs Blackwater, USA is a large donor to Trump's campaign.
Mm-hmm.
Now,
I can see that.
Now, what we just said is that the CEO of a mercenary company, I mean, we call them military contractors. That's the old word, was mercenary. That's what these people are from Blackwater, USA. And there's another company, one of their main competitors, there's like Blackwater and one other mercenary company in the United States that did that. Trump's probably got them too. But that, to me, gave me pause. Mm-hmm. I don't think that they could ever have enough mercenaries to take on the U.S. government in a coup attempt. And Blackwater's not that good, even though they're all ex-military. but when I heard that, I'm going, whoa. Why is he pardoning the mercenary dudes, man? What's he up to? But that would imply that I think he's capable of strategical thinking. And that was bad of me. Hit me. Thank you. Oh, dear, 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 dear.
So, you're so cute.
Oh, yeah, whatever. So let's see what's up with witchy stuff. I grabbed the pagan community notes from the Wild Hunt because it breaks down my pagan news in easy to digest little forms. Let's see. Headlines are.
And you like pictures and graphics and stuff.
Yeah, all that. Yeah, it works
like
really.
Trump has to have illustrations.
It totally helps me for radio. Pagan community notes. Pastor at Jericho March calls for death of witches. A heathen group challenges trademark application. Heathens react to Murdoch AFA decision and more news from the Wild Hunt. Washington on December 12, 2020, thousands of pro-Trump evangelical supporters gathered at the Jericho March at the National Mall to support the president's effort to overturn the 2020 election results and stop the steal. See, look at me. I'm trying to go over here into the witchy stuff, mm-hmm. You know, because we've been so political, because we've got to do radio for our spiritual side. Yeah. And we jumped over here to our spiritual side, and look, they're talking about Trump already. It's not our fault, man. All right, anyway, stop the steal. Groups of protesters and counter-protesters all gathered in front of the Supreme Court at Freedom Plaza. The Jericho March was described on its website as a prayer rally with speakers praying for the walls of corruption and election fraud to fall down. One speaker was Bishop Leon Benjamin of the New Life Harvest Church in Richmond, Virginia. That's the New Life Harvest Church in Richmond, Virginia. You may want to remember that later. Who ran for election to the U.S. House to represent Virginia's 4th Congressional District. He lost in the general election on November 3rd, 2020. Whew. At the Jericho rally, Bishop Benjamin held a shofar, a musical instrument made from the horn of a ram and used during important Jewish religious observances, and called on the, quote, patriots to announce that, quote, Jericho walls must come down, end quote, in the name of Jesus, who, quote, will rule in America, end quote. The call echoes the biblical story of Jericho, Joshua at Jericho. Bishop Benjamin proceeded into a denunciation of plaques in America. Wait, plaques? No, plagues? That's plagues this time.
Let me see. Yeah, that's plagues.
Plagues. Plagues in America, but primarily Marxism and witchcraft. We come together.
Well, we could have Marxists and plaques.
Yeah, we could totally do that. Here. Yeah.
So either way would be fine.
Witchy plaques? Okay.
Yeah. Marxist plaques?
Here we go. We are come together now, this is a quote, as American patriots, to let the Marxists know you will not have our educational system. You will not have our family system. You will not have our social media system. You will not have our religious systems. You will not have our governmental systems. The Jericho walls must come down, he yelled. The bishop then shouted, this is what I learned about witchcraft. You gotta tell a witch. You got to look them right in the eye and say, I'm coming after you. That's a bold strategy, Cotton. I mean, how that works out. This is your last day. This is your last time. Every curse you cursed against our president and against our nation is going to double fall back on your head. The Jericho walls must come down. Now, I must interject, as a witch, you get up on me and make a threat like that, I have to end you. My family's now in danger. You know, you're coming after me. No, I can't allow you to come after me. So, you know, if you're going to come after me, you just probably shouldn't tell me that, because if you do, then you dead, son of a bitch. Okay. Anyway, I ain't your grandma's witchcraft, man. We ain't going down like that.
It's Hammer.
Fuck. He further said, when you shout, and I got a few seconds now, but when you shout, shout at the devil, shout, just understand you're shouting for not only this generation, but you're shouting a legacy for the next generation, because the demons we kill now Our children will not have to fight. These devils, these are our devils, and we will kill them now. They will not bite our children. The Jericho walls must come down. Yeah, let's just scroll back up for just a minute, kids. Bishop Benjamin from the New Life Harvest Church in Richmond, Virginia. That's Bishop Benjamin, New Life Harvest Church, Richmond, Virginia. Trump's unhinged. Look at that headline.
Trump unhinged on CNN. Never thought I'd see the day.
Let's see.
Hospital surge.
Bishop Leon then blew the shofar and said that he could see the walls coming down.
That's who blew the shofar.
Now here... different story. This is where Marta was pointing to hammer, because there was a Thor's hammer on the page. Denver last year, former Sidere of America, FSOA, formally filed for and received nonprofit status as a church. Around the time of their filing, they received a cease and desist letter alleging they had committed trademark infringement from the company identified itself as Foreign Sidere and purported to be an established in Norway, Canada, and the U.S. Foreign Sidere, pronounced Foreign Sidere, I did perfectly, I don't have to have it spelled out, of America, immediately turned the letter over to the attorney who advised them to also file the trademark within the U.S. The trademark seems to be the Thor's hammer itself. FSOA grew out of a Facebook group, Shield Wall of the Rockies, that was created in the fall of 2018 to provide a place for people in the region of Colorado and surrounding area who were interested in heathenry that was focused on inclusivity and progressive values. By September 2018, the group's size had grown, and they're receiving members from all over the U.S. and other countries. At that point, they changed the group's name to Shield Wall of North America to better reflect the people who made up the group. A number of the people interested in joining the Facebook group continued to expand. An attempt to meet the expressed goals and desires of those joining the group, the administrators decided to create a formal group, write bylaws, and eventually file for a nonprofit church status. They changed their name to the Foreign Sidere of America to reflect the values their members expressed. I'm scrolling through this because it's boring. I don't know if this is the story that I thought it was. Well, at any rate, they're fighting over this symbol that looks very much like the Thor's hammer, and that's rather
silly. They're fighting over the Thor's hammer?
Yeah, like one of them owns it or something. let's see. Oh, okay, I think this may be the one that I thought it was. Let me scroll up to the top headlines. Archer's death was just heathen group challenges trademark. Heathens react to Murdoch decision. Okay, so yeah, I don't know what the Murdoch decision is, so I have to go to my other community notes. Again, from the Wild Hunt, first Native American named to Interior Secretary. Petition filed against the AFA and Kilauea erupts. More news. Last week, President-elect Joe Biden formally announced Republican or Representative Rep.
Why would Joe Biden formally announce a Republican?
Oh, yeah.
So you have to use your brain.
I just reading. Okay. Deb Haaland. and his nominee to head the U.S. Department of the Interior, the DOI, If Holland is confirmed by the Senate, it will be the first time in U.S. history that a Native American has held a cabinet position. Holland is a member of the Pueblo Laguna tribe of New Mexico and won her seat to serve in Congress, representing the first congressional district. Mm-hmm. And is Trump going to call her Pocahontas? That would be fascinating.
Well, he'll be gone, so who cares?
Yeah. Let's see, what was the other one? But petition filed against the AFA. What's that? In an update previous recording about Murdoch County's December 9th vote to allow the permit of the Ozatru Folk Assembly to operate an online petition has been created on change.org to block the permit. While the town's population is small with only 275 people so far, as petition has collected over 116,000 signatures. The AFA purchased the defunct Lutheran church this year, and the residents in the area have been vocal about their opposition to the AFA establishing base. Don Wilcox, the attorney for the city of Murdoch, cited legal concerns if the city council voted to deny the permit prior to vote. Other concerns about how the meeting was conducted. Minnesota law states that local governments meeting remotely must vote on an individual roll call. The city council. I don't even know what that story's about. I was hoping we'd get to the point, but not much of a point to that. What else we got here? Hawaii's Kilauea volcano erupted, spewing lava into the air and causing.
Do you remember what side of the island that was on?
The middle.
Was it the middle?
Yeah,
it was the middle. Is it?
Okay. Yeah, the whole all the life kind
remember
of goes around.
Remember when we took that drive all the way around the entire island?
Yep.
That was cool. We saw the windmills and stuff. Mm-hmm. We were at the southernmost part of the United States.
But now it's spewing lava in the air.
So it's in the middle? It's not where we threw the thing wrapped in the...
Well, that's part of it. That was like a steam vent of the volcano.
Yeah, so was it that volcano?
Yeah, though? I mean, the island is the volcano, and there's just places where people can live around the edges pretty much. It's like it's a huge, massive thing. Massive plume of steam and gases, 30,000 feet into the atmosphere. Eruption began after a series of earthquakes. Last erupted in May of 2018. Lava continued to flow for 4 months. But I remember when we were there, it's like it had been going for like decades, but it was just like, I guess this is different when it spews it, but it just like is continually flowing lava out of the thing, but I guess that's different than an eruption. I don't know. I'm just looking around, seeing if I see any stories. Oh, those all look very boring. I'm not going to bother you. The Satanic Temple set billboards placed in Miami, Dallas, and Houston that feature the slogan, abortion slaves save lives.
Abortion what?
Abortions save lives. The billboard in Dallas was installed last week and will be in place until mid-January. TST seeks to use billboards to make any Satanists in the area aware of TST's abortion ritual, which involves reflecting on the satanic tenets and personal affirmation that can be done while receiving an abortion. The Satanic Temple's religious reproductive rights spokesperson, Sydney Goldwyn, told the Daily Observer, it's a process to provide the spiritual sustenance in a satanic way. She went on to explain that the ritual provides spiritual comfort and feelings of self-worth during what some consider to be a difficult time. And all of the billboards are near crisis pregnancy centers, which are often mistaken for abortion centers and seek to persuade women with unwanted pregnancies to carry their pregnancies to term rather than choose to abort. September, the TST announced that it had filed a lawsuit of religious discrimination against Larimar Advertising in Arkansas state court. After the company rejected designs TST had submitted for the billboards, calling their content misleading and offensive. According to the suit, the Texas GOP released a statement last Thursday stating it would relentlessly work to end all abortions in the state during the next legislative session, regardless of what state lawmakers or the TST's critics might think of Goodwin said. Satanists have religious views in accordance to our tenets. Us demanding medical care in accordance to our religious views as required by law is a right that should be guaranteed to us. Well, she's got to love the Satanists out there, man. Doing it for us all.
Yep.
Setting a good example. And they got way better Ten Commandments than the Ten Commandments ever was.
I really feel like the Satanists have, in general as a whole, have more integrity than the anti-Satanists.
Yeah. If you look at their version of the Ten Commandments, it's way superior to Old Testament. Hmm. Yeah. So look that up and read it. But we're not Satanists.
Yeah, we're not Satanists.
We can still read it.
But we don't, we don't have a problem with Satanists.
No.
Doesn't mean we are Satanists, but yeah. We don't have a problem with Satanists.
Ain't no Satanists ever tried to burn my kind, basically. All right, we'll play something.
I slip on the ice. Santa Claus been looking. Who's been naughty? Who's been nice? I'm looking for one thing real tonight.
bucket full of paste. He rips off my ear and says, glue this to my face. I'd like to leave America for some place where
lords of the new church on Widdershins Radio.
Widdershins.
Something you probably never heard unless you listen to Widdershins Radio. I don't know where you would hear it, but it's an epic song. I can't think of another good song that they had on their album. But for the TikTok witches that asked me about my favorite band, I told them I was going to play some Damned tonight. Well, it's Brian James, the guitarist for the Damned, and his when he broke off from the Damned, that was his first project, was Lords of the New Church, and that at least was an epic song. I should look. They may have had more, but that song was just so epic. And the video, you know, look it up on YouTube. You'll see the video. Like back for the 80s, it was, you know, epic special effects. A post-nuclear apocalyptic scene that all of us in the 80s thought for sure was, you know, coming any day. I guess now we think of that again. And then there was Dan Byrne, which a lot of people probably haven't heard of Dan Byrne either, but we play a lot of Dan Byrne. I think that's his most famous song was the Tiger Woods song. That got some airplay. I got big balls, that kind of thing.
That should be Mojo's song.
Yes, we could play that for. Yes, that we can decide what Mojo's song is.
I already decided.
Okay, then we have decided that is now Mojo's song. Oh, I actually have that song. I'm just like looking through some of the songs that I have. Dan Byrne. Let's see. what was I going to tell you about? Oh, yes, that was the thing. Hopefully, now we have a vaccine coming. You know, maybe we'll get back to some sort of normal life, you know, those of us that are left alive in the coming future. But last year, when Hexfest came, people putting on a Hex Fest decided rather than cancel their festival, like most magical festivals were doing, they decided to come up with something totally new. And then after that, other magical festivals, probably seeing what they had done, followed suit and actually did it in the same format. And several festivals were saved. A lot of these magical and pagan gathering festivals that happened, you know, some of them are, you know, they're rather small, and, you know, 1 year of no revenue can just kill them, you know, not like, you know, Pantheacon back in the day, you know, they did rather well, but, you know, some of these other ones, just like 1 year off, and there's no money to do next year's thing, and some of those were able to figure out a way around that, and, you know, for magical people, you know, witches and whatnot, that should always be our way. We need to, you know, we look at the tides and the ebbs and the flows, and we do that to figure out how we're going to do what we're going to do. We're going to do what we're going to do, but we're just looking at those tides and those ebbs and those flows to figure out the best time to do what we're going to do or how we're going to work around those ebbs and those flows. But no witch worth their pointy hat ever just didn't do what they were going to do because of an ebb or a fucking flow. No witches I know. So you bend with the times. You figure out, you know, what is the path of least resistance and how can I resist that path or work around that path or under it or over it or something or weave my way up through it in a way that doesn't offer resistance. So this is the way a witch, in my estimation, should be thinking. So Hexfest did that last year and hopefully won't have to do that this year. We'll see how that goes. But in how awesome Hexfest Digital Online turned out this year was born a whole new festival. And I'm talking WitchCon. And WitchCon is a digital festival. WitchCon will not be affected by any future pandemics or things of its kind. As long as the internet works, WitchCon will work. WitchCon's born off of that idea using some of those same formats, but as such, just blew the hell up. And there's well over 100 presenters, so I can't even read them all to you. It would take forever. But I'll give you the address, witchcon.com. Let's see what it says here. Bring the magic to you. March 5th to the 7th, 2021. Join the largest online magical conference in the world, featuring over 100 witches and conjurers coming to you by live stream from video from across the globe. Watch classes live, then watch on demand whenever you want. This is, the social interaction of going to one of these festivals is cool and all, but you miss so much. There's only so many notes you can take, and most people won't let you know, video their workshop. This format offers so much more possibilities for study. March 5th to the 7th, 2021, Brian King, Christian Day, and the Hex Education Network present WitchCon online, featuring over 100 classes by over 100 witches, conjurers across the globe. Share their time-honored wisdom and witchery with beginners and advanced practitioners alike. WitchCon online presenters are the preeminent masters of the magical arts and hail from across the rainbow spectrum of occult and spiritual practices. Registration is limited to 1,000 attendees. It includes all live video classes, rituals, and performances, as well as access to recordings of every class after the event has ended via our on-demand library, so you won't miss a single magical moment. Attendees and fans will love the live shopping and the virtual vendorium, featuring powerful ritual tools, signed books, exquisite jewelry, and handmade spellcrafts. Our virtual meet and greet lets attendees and fans alike meet and chat with presenters live on Zoom, and is a great way to get to know your favorite teachers. And I think me and Marta will be there. I am one of the presenters, and we did that last time for Hex, but we'll be popping into the virtual meet and greet, right?
For what?
For WitchCon.
Yeah, totally.
Virtual meet and greet.
Yeah.
You don't have to go anywhere.
Yeah.
Just, go to the computer, go to the phone.
I can do that.
Okay. Marta's going to be there too. Let's see. WitchCon Online 2021 presenters are the preeminent masters of the magical arts, tale from the rainbow spectrum of the thing that I just said. Each of them are engaging teachers and offer classes personally designed to help beginners, novices, and experts alike expand their magical knowledge and power. All right. I will read a few of them. There are too many to read them all. Brian Kane, Christian Day, A.C. Fisher Aldag, Alexander Cabot, Alexis Ariando, Amy Blackthorne, Andreas Corbin, Angie Buchanan. I'm going to scroll up because it's all alphabetical. Crystal Madison, Lady Kate Henriette Jaw, Lady Rhea, Lori Cabot. Whoa. Lori Cabot? Oh my God. I haven't read the list. Lori Cabot's on the list. Yeah. Oh my God. Leanne Marmar, Levi Rowland, Lilith Dorsey, Madam Z, Martha Gonzalez, Barry Grace Farhoon, Melanie Marquis, Michael Carell, look at that, Michael Faree, Michael Herkes, I'm scrolling up so I can just give you a sampling of all of them. Phyllis Carat, Priestess Miriam, Rachel Patterson, Rebecca Spirit, Reverend Paul Beryl. Wow, Beryl, dude, our favorite books.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking about Compendium of Herbal Magic and the other one. Robert M. Place, Sandra Wright, Sean Weil, San Elias, Shashid Mitro, Shannon Marie Deru, Star Cassis, Sarita Deste, Star Ravenhawk, Tess Whitehurst, Thorn Mooney, the Buckland Museum of Witchcraft and Magic. The whole museum is going to be there. Val Hughes, Witch Doctor Utu. Oh, Yeshe Matthews. She always gets on the end there until somebody comes up with a name that has a Z. But that's just a sampling of the over 100 presenters. I didn't even know. Lori Cabot. I mean, I never wanted to be on the same bill with Silver Ravenwolf, but still, you know, impressive, you know, for notoriety's sake, but on the same bill with Lori Cabot. Mm-hmm. Wow. That's something. WitchCon, y'all. WitchCon.com. And, wait, let me see. Where was the... Hold on, I'll look at the registration, because it was cheap. I forgot. It was
it's
so...
like 90-something?
Yeah, it's like $100 or something.
Yeah, something like that.
I don't know how they're paying me, but they're paying me. $95, dude. $95 for all of that. And you're going to have it, like, archived and be able to watch all of these workshops over and over again. Anything you missed, you can be able to watch it. Like, sit there like we did with Hexfest and just, like, binge watch all the workshops. You can do that. There's more options, you know. That's one thing good COVID did for us, I guess. Gave us options. Oh dear. Here listening to Wittershins Radio, and you gotta follow. You gotta follow. We're still just giving you like the tip of our package. We can go 3 hours a day, unlimited times per day. It was like if there was something really going on in the world and we had nothing else to do, which you know, we're on lockdown like everybody else, so you know, we probably could do that if something really, you know, that good was going on. Could go on for 3 hours, turn it off, start it again, go on for 3 hours, turn it off, start it again, go on for 3 hours, all day long. We did it for 9 hours one time just to see if we could really do what we thought we could do. We can do that. And if you're not following, you'll never know when we did that. Now, we're at spreaker.com/user/Wittershins, but also we're on, you know, iHeartRadio and Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, all these other places. Every one of those places, it's got to have a subscribe or a follow or something like that. And you just won't know. You just won't know. Even if you subscribe to the YouTube broadcast, you know, our first broadcast would post to YouTube letting you know that we were still broadcasting for another, like if we theoretically, hypothetically, did that thing where we went on for 3 hours and then another 3 hours and another 3 hours. You would even find out about that on YouTube. You just find out a little late for the first broadcast. But then you'd be able to tune in over here. You would know to just, you know, wherever you're at, whatever format you're on, whatever crew you run with, whatever set you're from, there's a follow or a subscribe type of button or checkbox near you that with very little effort you could go click thereupon and just create a whole different world for all of us, for both you and us. It's Widdershins. And I think we've got to rock out a bit more.
Okay.
I think I have to.
Give me a T.
T.
Give me an R.
R.
Give me an E.
E.
Give me an A.
A.
Give me an S.
S.
Give me an O.
O.
Give me an N.
N.
What's that spell?
Treason.
What's that spell?
Treason.
One more time.
Treason.
You're all going to get arrested. My name is John Riley. I'll have your ear only a while. I left my dear home in Ireland. It was death, starvation, or exile. When I got to America, it was my duty to go. Enter the army and slog across Texas to join in the war against Mexico. And it was there in the pueblos and hillsides that I saw the mistake I had made. Part of a conquering army with the morals of a bayonet blade. And there amidst all these poor dying Catholics, screaming children, the burning stench of it all, myself and 200 Irishmen decided to rise to the call. From Dublin City to San Diego, we witnessed freedom denied. So we formed the St. Patrick Battalion, and we fought on the Mexican side. We formed the St. Patrick Battalion, and we fought on the Mexican side. We marched neath the green flag of St. Patrick, emblazoned with Erin Gobra, bright with the harp and the shamrock, and Libertad para Mexicana. Just 50 years after Wolf Tone, 5,000 miles away, the Yanks called us a legion of strangers, and they can talk as they may. But from Dublin City to San Diego, we witnessed freedom denied. So we formed the St. Patrick Battalion, and we fought on the Mexican side. We formed the St. Patrick Battalion, and we fought on the Mexican side. We fought them in Matamoros, where their volunteers were raping the nuns. In Monterrey and Cerro Gordo, we fought on as Ireland's sons. We were the red-headed fighters for freedom amidst these brown-skinned women and men. Side by side we fought against tyranny, and I dare say we'd do it again. From Dublin City to San Diego, we witnessed freedom denied. So we formed the St. Patrick Battalion, and we fought on the Mexican side. We formed the St. Patrick Battalion, and we fought on the Mexican side. Fought them in 5 major battles. Churubusco was the last. Overwhelmed by the cannons from Boston, we fell after each mortar blast. Most of us died on that hillside in the service of the Mexican state. So far from our occupied homeland, we were heroes and victims of fate. From Dublin City to San Diego, we witnessed freedom denied. So we formed the St. Patrick Battalion, and we fought on the Mexican side. From Dublin City to San Diego, we witnessed freedom denied. So we formed the St. Patrick Battalion, and we fought on the Mexican side. We formed the St. Patrick Battalion, and we fought on the Mexican side.
Well, this is the longest session I have ever been in my life, and my voice is about to fall apart, so I'm going to sing the last one. Rather, we are. I bet if I was to make a book right now about what that song was, I wouldn't make very much money. Hmm? Which one is it? Well, all right. I mean, what the hell? When the Union's inspiration through the workers' blood shall run, there can be no power greater anywhere beneath the sun. Yet what force on earth is weaker than the feeble strength of one? But the Union makes us strong. Solidarity forever, solidarity forever, solidarity forever, for the Union makes us strong. us into serfdom and would crush us with his might. Is there anything left to us but to organize and fight? For the union makes us strong. Solidarity forever. Solidarity forever. Solidarity forever. For the union makes us strong. It is we who plowed the prairies, built the cities where they trade, dug the mines and built the workshops, endless miles of railroad laid. We stand outcast and starve amidst the wonders we have made, but the union makes us strong. Solidarity forever. Solidarity forever. Solidarity forever. For the union makes us strong. All the world that's owned by idle drones is ours and ours alone. We have laid the wide foundation, built it skyward stone by stone. It is ours not to slave in, but to master and to own, while the union makes us strong. Solidarity forever. Solidarity forever. Solidarity forever. They have taken untold millions that they never toiled to earn. But without our brain and muscle, not a single wheel can turn. We can break their haughty power, gain our freedom when we learn that the union makes us strong. Solidarity forever. Solidarity forever. Solidarity forever. In our hands is placed a power greater than their hoarded gold, greater than the might of armies magnified a thousandfold. We can bring to birth a new world from the ashes of the old, for the union makes us strong. Solidarity forever. Solidarity forever. Solidarity forever.
Speech fight of 1910, and was introduced on the streets of Spokane by Haywire Mac McClintock. He was a branch secretary then. He wrote Big Rock Candy Mountain and Hallelujah I'm a Bum. He got together a little band, T-Bone Slim, a tuba, a garbage can lid. They stood in a doorway, waiting to leap out at the unemployed throng and regale them with song. They used a shill to build the crowd. You know, a carny shill? Somebody uses tricks to build a crowd. I think his name was Tresca, but he wore a black suit, a black bowler hat, a string tie with an umbrella and a briefcase, looked like a banker. He'd walk down where they were hiding in the doorway, and suddenly he'd start to yell, "Help! Help! Help! I've been robbed! Help! I've been robbed!" Everybody'd run across the street. "What's the matter? What's the matter?" As soon as he got the crowd together, he'd yell, "I've been robbed by the capitalist system, fellow workers!" He'd talk to them for 10 minutes, and then the boys would leap out and start singing, and this is what they were singing. "The long-haired preachers come out every night. I try to tell you what's wrong and what's right. But when asked about something to eat, they will answer in voices so sweet. You will eat by and by in that glorious land in the sky, way up high, work and pray, live on hay. You'll get by in the sky when you die. That's a lie." Oh, that's real nice. Let's take a minute and teach the folks that don't know this what this is. Now, this is done Baptist style. Are there any Baptists here? Oh, good. Answer back, you know, where I sing one thing and then you sing it back and then we sing a line together. And the way up highs are yours. Not mine. They're the prettiest part of the whole song. You will eat.
You will eat.
By and by.
By and by.
In that glorious land in the sky.
Way up high.
Work and pray.
Work and pray.
Live on hay.
Live on hay.
And you'll get pie in the sky when you die.
That's a lie.
The long-haired preachers come out every night. I try to tell you what's wrong and what's right. But when asked about something to eat, they'll answer in voices so sweet. Hey, you will eat,
you will eat.
By and by.
By and by.
In that glorious land in the sky.
Yeah,
I work and pray.
Work and pray.
Live on hay.
Live on hay.
Hey, you'll get by in the sky when you die.
That's a lie.
The Starvation Army, they play. And they shout and they clap and they pray. When they've got all your coins on the drum, they will tell you when you're on the bum. Hey, you will eat
by and by.
In that glorious land in the sky.
Work and pray.
Live on hay. You'll get by in the sky when you die.
That's a lie.
Working folks of all countries unite. Side by side, we for freedom shall fight. When this world and its wealth we have gained, the grafters will sing this refrain. Hey,
you will eat
by and by.
By, and by.
When you've learned how to cook and how to fry, chop some wood, that do you good. And you'll eat in that sweet by and by.
That's no lie.
Oh, why don't you work like other folks do? How can I get a job when you're holding down two? Hallelujah, I'm a bum.
Hallelujah, I'm a bum again.
Hallelujah, give us a handout to revive us again. Oh, I went to a house and I knocked on the door. The lady said, "Scram bum, you've been here before."
Hallelujah, I'm a bum.
Hallelujah, bum again. Hallelujah, give us a handout to revive us again. Yeah, I went to that house and I asked for some bread. The lady said, "Scram bum, the baker is dead."
Hallelujah, I'm a bum.
Hallelujah, bum again. Hallelujah, give us a handout to revive us again. There I am in Spookaloo, city of magic, city of light. Ensconced upon my front porch in broad daylight, long about noon, my rising time. Drinking something of a potable beverage, playing my guitar. Long after everybody else in the neighborhood has packed up their lunchbox and gone off down to Kaiser Aluminum to put in their shift. This enrages my neighbors. One in particular across the road, little retired banker fella, been known to cannonball his rotundity across the road and stand there and publicly berate me for my sloth and indolence. "Why don't you get a job?" he says. Some of you heard that, I'll bet. Now me being hip to the Socratic method fires back a question. Why? "Why," he says, taken aback, "if you had a job, you could make $3, $4, or $5 an hour." I said, "Why?" pursuing the same tack. Said, "Hell, you make $3, $4, or $5 an hour, you could have a savings account, save up some of that money." I said, "Why?" He said, "Well, you save up enough of that money, young fella. Pretty soon you never have to work another day in your life." Said, "Hell, that's what I'm doing right now." Oh, I like my boss, he's a good friend of mine. That's why I'm starving out on the bread line. Hallelujah, I'm a bum.
Hallelujah, bum again.
Hallelujah, give us a handout to revive us again. Yeah, and I like Jim Hill, he's a good friend of mine. Say, that's why I'm booming down Jim Hill's main line. Hallelujah, I'm a bum.
Hallelujah, bum again.
Hallelujah, give us a handout to revive us again. I guess pretty soon I'll be headed back to Spokane, take up my task of wintering in, and I do a little light farming or heavy gardening, whichever. But you know, that kind of farming is hard if you're in this traveling profession. And of course, when you sing like I do, you got to be ready to travel with considerable alacrity. I got a Greyhound bus ticket in my back pocket all the time. But you see, quite often I'm not back in town in time for my plowing or my planting. That's awful. But now, one time I was sharing a platform in New York City, it was, with a bunch of high-powered labor politicos. It was a benefit for the farm workers, that's what it was. I remember Richard Chavez, Cesar's brother, was there. And so was Bella Abzug, former congresswoman from the state of New York. Remember her? Wonderful woman. I mean, she was loud, vociferous, big hats. She was yelling at that audience, righteous beef it was, about how the feds, the FBI, had been opening her mail for ever so long. Well, I knew the feds had been opening my mail for at least 20 years, reading all my personal radical mail, and it never bothered me because I figured them birds had to learn that stuff somewhere, and it might as well be from my mail. But then it occurred to me in my predicament, having the FBI open your mail might come in handy. I sent Sheila, my partner, a letter through the United States Mail. I said in it, "For God's sake, don't plow up the backyard. That's where the guns are buried." National Guard rolled up, dug up the whole backyard in time for me to come back and plant the damn thing. Oh, I went to a bar and I asked for a drink. He gave me a glass and he showed me the thing. Hallelujah, I'm a bum. Hallelujah, bum again. Hallelujah, give us a handout to revive us again. Whenever I get all the money I earn, the boss will be broke and to work he must turn. Hallelujah, I'm a bum. Hallelujah, bum again. Hallelujah, give us a handout to revive us again. And why don't you save all the money you earn? If I didn't eat, I'd have money to burn. Hallelujah, I'm a bum. Hallelujah, bum again. Hallelujah, give us a handout to revive us again.
And it's way, hey, where the Red Queen reigns, from her throne upon the sea with the hot rum running in our veins. We will serve you steel for tea. Took ship at 12 years old, a lad both young and green. A score years since I'm a pirate bold, and many's the sight I seen. But the finest sight I seen by far, from Port Royal to Malabar, in time of peace or time of war, is Anne the Pirate Queen. And it's way, hey, where the Red Queen reigns, from her throne upon the sea, with the hot rum running in our veins. We will serve you steel for tea. With a black flag dancing overhead, we will salt your beef with flying lead, and you'll regret that ever you fed at the board of Anthony. Now some will rue their sailor's trade when they see the bo'sun glare, and some will quake at the scrape of blades where powder smokes the air. But the bravest tar who ever sailed would sooner face a roaring gale than feel his heart within him fail at the flash of Anne's red hair. And it's away, hey, where the Red Queen reigns, from her throne upon the sea, with the hot rum running in our veins. We will serve you steel for tea. With a black flag dancing overhead, we will salt your beef with flying lead, and you'll regret that ever you fed at the board of Anne Bonny. silly sheep, we'll shear you head to heel. We made the jolly Dutchman weep and the haughty Spaniard kneel. Come brig and frigate, sloop and snow, we'll strip you clean and sink you low to take your grog with Davy Joe beneath the rolling keel. And it's way, hey, where the Red Queen reigns from her throne up on the sea, with the hot rum running in our veins. We will serve you steel for tea. With a black flag dancing overhead, we will salt your beef with flying lead, and you'll regret that ever you fed at the board of Anbonny. It's rum and plunder, ho! My heart's a ship is trim and true. We'll set a course for distant parts and foreign revenue. We sail upon the morning tide to strop our blades on merchant hide, and we'll get glory, gold, and pride on Captain Bonnie's crew. And it's way, hey, where the Red Queen reigns from her throne up on the sea, with the hot rum running in our veins. We will serve you steel for tea. With a black flag dancing overhead, we will salt your beef with flying lead, and you'll regret that ever you fed at the port of Anbonny. Tummy way, hey, where the Red Queen reigns. Queen Red.